Alrighty, what is up guys? Welcome back to Kush Claws TV, and today I'm going to be showing you guys all the new customizations I've done to the Huffy Neluso Lowrider Beach Cruiser project that I got going on here. So if you guys haven't seen my video of me purchasing the bike and also doing some customization with the tires and whatnot, I'll make sure to put a link of the original video or the first video in the comments below. But a couple weeks ago, or about a month ago or so, I bought this bike here at Walmart for $109. It's actually a really good deal. And I went and did some other stuff to it. I actually bought a beach cruiser from Walmart prior to that, 6 months ago, before that. And it is actually over there. That was the Hyper beach cruiser. It is actually dismantled right now. There is the gold rims with the red tires from the Neluso. But yeah, in that video when I bought it, I went through the white walls on there to give it that really nice, you know, just kind of classic look. I like the white walls better than I did the red rims, even though the red tires, even though I do like the red tires. But yeah, today I'm going to be showing you guys some more customizations that I've done to it. Also, real quickly, shout out to Optimistic Reality. He commented on the first video that I did on the Huffy Neluso. So he was asking why I don't have, or why I haven't done some low rider front forks for the front of the beach cruiser. And the main reason is where the area that I live at, it's basically impossible to try to get some low rider parts for cars or even for bicycles. It's literally impossible to get low rider cars, or you know, car or parts for low rider cars or trucks. It's a little bit easier, you know, there are some spots to actually go and get some stuff, but bicycle low rider parts, it's basically impossible nowadays. Back in the day, used to be able to, but now around here I really can't. So I got to find a replicable source online to try to source out some lowrider parts. I used to go through Lovely Lowriders, is I believe what it used to be called back in like 05 06. I used to go through them, but yeah, I gotta find a reliable source to get some stuff. I would like to try to find some black twisted front forks for the front of the beach cruiser, if not maybe chrome to match the chrome handlebars. But also, you know, like I said, I wouldn't mind going all black, and then also trying to find some black handlebars as well that are some ape hangers. And then, of course, change out the pedals, you know, maybe get some twisted stuff as well. I like the twisted metal a lot. And then, yeah, just I wouldn't mind doing some stuff like that. And then, of course, get the Springer and stuff like that. I forgot my other lowrider bikes in the garage, or I'll show you what I was talking about. But the little lowrider Springer in the front, I wouldn't mind putting that on there. And, yeah, but like I said, it's really difficult, so I have to wait to do that. But for right now, I am working with what I got, which is Walmart. And even amidst with the coronavirus, for some reason, even bicycle customization stuff is going out of stock for some reason. But yeah, so what I've done so far is I've gotten some lights, obviously. I went and got, I had already lights for other bikes. So, and then of course I got some more, but I have, let's see here. I have two blue ones of these GoBrights here. I have two blue ones for the frame here, and I also have two green ones for the back of the frame here, which you see right there, and then the two blue ones for the front. What I originally wanted to do was all blue, so I wanted two in the back here, two in the frame, and then I wanted to put two in the front forks. And then also I have wheel lights here, which they were in stock a couple days ago. My back one here actually kind of came off. I didn't have it completely secured, this battery pack here, and it kind of came off, wrapped up, and snapped right off and broke, so I had to get a new one. So we got that there. We got these wheel lights here. They actually look really nice, and I'll do a I'll show you guys here a couple clips of what it looks like all lit up at night, as well as do a little drive-by video, if you will, so you can see what it looks like you know, riding at night with all the lights and everything. But yeah, I have two of these brights here. If you're wondering how much they cost, if you can find them in stock, because they're out of stock right now, these are $10 a piece. And then same with these here. These here are in stock, and they have them in all colors, green, red, and blue, and all of their stuff. Those there as well, $10 a piece. And then also we have an upgraded sound system here. Before my other bikes, I used little mini Bluetooth speakers. It was the first time I actually ever put a sound system, like little, you know, mini Bluetooth speakers on a bike before. You know, before that, back in the day, I actually had ones that would hooked up to a CD player, and you'd have to put double A's in, which was funny. Also, real quickly, these here take triple A's. These here take double A's. Two triple A's per light, three triple A's for wheel light for those. But yeah, I was all, recently I was using like the little mini Baby Boom XL Bluetooth speaker and stuff, or like the mini life jacket. and I would strap it to, you know, maybe the center here of the handlebars, or like if I have a basket now, I just throw it in the basket, you know. And also, if you want to put a little quick sound system too, you know, you just throw a little mini Bluetooth speaker in there, no problem. If you got a cup holder, you can get the round cup holder Bluetooth speakers. Me, I prefer something a little bit better than that, because those speakers really don't have that much bass and they're really not too loud. But so I went and decided to get something a little step up. This here is a party speaker. It is a Rave mini speaker. It has a subwoofer in it. It has mids, 80 watts. It is rechargeable Bluetooth, has app, lights, everything, DJ stuff, bunch of crap. And yeah, 80 watts, and it is loud. It pounds. All right, I've literally pulled up next to cars and they had to turn their system up. And when they turned their system up, my stuff still was louder and also outpound their car. Literally, like, this thing thumps, this little party speaker here. And yeah, it's a Rave, it's an Anker Rave Mini. And it's, I believe this one here just has one mid and, or yeah, one mid and one subwoofer, and the other one's just a dummy. You got lights over here and over there. But yeah, this thing here, just the, even the mini thumps. This here is, if you get it on sale, $100. Normally, if you don't get it on sale, $150. If you step up to the regular Anker Rave, then not the mini, then you get the extra speaker there, so you have two mids and a sub. But yeah, my light's going off, my battery's dying on my phone here, I'm about to charge it up, but I'll show you guys what it looks like all lit up. Also, real quickly, of course, I have a little headlight right up here, right? And the back here, I had a Schwinn taillight as well. I decided to take that out, and I decided to get one of these here. I actually had one of these little LED lights in red, and a little idea popped in my head, or a light popped in my head, light bulb. And I decided to put one in red in the back here, so it looks like I have a custom LED tail light, which is pretty cool. So instead of having just that normal Schwinn one in the back, I got like a little LED strip there that's red that I'm going to have on when I'm riding at night. And of course, the main thing I like about these lights is that people can see you at night, because there's a lot of people that just don't pay attention at night. And yeah, I've almost been hit plenty of times. Like, just even recently, I've probably almost been hit about 3-4 times in the past 48 hours. But yeah, there's a reason why I have all these lights here. You know, not only do they look cool, you know, it serves a purpose. People can see you. But yeah, I'm gonna charge my phone up here, and I will show you guys what the bike looks up all lit up, as well as a couple little drive-by clips, and I'll make sure to put some music over that. And I'm done talking. Make sure to have a great day or night, all in 24 hours. Peace. And go ahead and check out these clips, and then after that, make sure to have a great day or night, and see you next time. I got neon in my trunk, I got bass in my trunk, I got shit if I get caught, I catch a case in my trunk, I got bricks in my trunk, I got pounds in my trunk, I got speakers and they banging, that's around in my trunk, that's 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 in my trunk, they talking down, they talking down, we get it crunk, we get it crunk, we got the funk, we got the funk, that's in my trunk, that's in my trunk. I'm a dirty south nigga, bitch, I'm all about the cash. Bands up in the mattress, nigga, work up in the stash. Got a pack of trio niggas rolling with me down the mash. I hop up in the forest, started up and hit the gas. I'm smoking on that kilo, rolled up in a Rillo. I'm serving all the fiends, burning butter on a Brillo. I got a couple thousand, trying to stack it to a Milo. It's gonna take a couple weeks, but I'ma get there, that's for real though. Dollars and finessing, and some fly motherfuckers, you can tell by how we dressing. Dressing after us for years, but nigga, we ain't learn our lesson. Got niggas in the grave and niggas in the pen, and the same shit they was doing, we out here doing again. Don't make a lot of sense, but we don't give a fuck. All we know is popping pistols, popping seals, and popping trunks. I got neon in my trunk, I got